Jack and pinion actuator, anodized aluminum, limit switch to solenoid, assembly of cord set and receptacle. Back out the captive cover bolts on the limit switch box and remove the cover. Remove the plastic cap from the conduit entry. Feed the wires of the receptacle through the hole. Thread the receptacle into the port and tighten with a wrench. The green wire is the ground and the blue and the brown wires are the solenoid leads. The wiring diagram is on the inside of the limit switch box. The dashed lines indicate the location of the brown and blue wire connections. Assemble an electrical connector to the end of the green ground wire. Secure the ground wire to the ground screw at the base of the limit switch box. Move any loose wires away from the cams and micro switches. The brown wire will go on the back of terminal 8 and the blue wire will go on the back of terminal 7. Loosen the screws in the terminal strip and insert the blue and the brown wires. Secure the wires by tightening the terminal strip screws. Secure any loose wiring and place the cover back on the top of the limit switch box. Tighten the bolts on the cover. Remove the screw and remove the DIN connector from the solenoid valve. Place the gasket over the solenoid side of the cord set. Slide over the tabs of the coil and secure with the screw. The other end of the cord set is a male receptacle with a male keyway. The receptacle has a female keyway. Make sure they are in alignment. Thread the cord set into the receptacle and tighten the nut. Rack and pinion actuator, anodized aluminum, limit switch to solenoid, assembly of cord set and receptacle.